Tonight, you came out very strong on the issue of immigration, and do you think that Joe Biden's stance of working with Republicans is helpful or unhelpful on that issue?
Well, I don't think the metric is whether somebody works with Republicans. It's fine to work with Republicans. The difference is, what are you standing up for? And tonight, we had a conversation about what we need to stand up for. We saw that heartbreaking image yesterday of Oscar Alberto Martinez Ramirez and his daughter Valeria. They made that dangerous journey across the river specifically because this administration is playing games with people who are trying to claim asylum at our ports of entry. They tried to claim asylum at a port of entry the way that you're supposed to do, and they were denied. They were not allowed to do what for generations people have been allowed to do because of the Trump administration. Because of their frustration, they went and tried to cross that river, and that's when they died. That should not happen to anybody who is trying to claim asylum. That's why I talked about ending this policy of metering when I become president. We need to repeal Section 1325 of the Immigration and Nationality Act, because that's the very law that allows for the federal government to rip away little children from their parents. And we need to go back to the way we used to treat this between 1929 and about 2004. In the vast majority of cases, we treated it as a civil violation. So this is not something that's radical, that we've never done before. This doesn't mean that people are not part of a process. There's still a court process. People are still have to show up to a court hearing. They are still subject to deportation. But we need to choose common sense and compassion and family values.
I've been dealing with it.
Over cruelty. Yeah,
so, what will
Central
you
America,
doing?
What would you do with the source of the problem? The reason that we've now have a record for the last 13 years of undocumented immigrants coming in is because they have a problem down there. How would you address that?
I would partner with those countries so that people can find safety and opportunity in Honduras or El Salvador or Guatemala instead of having to come over here. And let me just say, you know, this president has been such a terrible failure on this issue. You remember 2014, we had a lot of people also that came from Central America, and they also came in 2015, 2016, right before this president became president, they were coming. On January of 2017, when he became president, he knew that this was an issue. He's wasted the last 2.5 years talking a big game, trying to get money for his wall, being a total failure on this issue. He has nothing to show for it. If I had been president, I would have gone immediately to those three countries and worked with them so that people could find safety and opportunity there instead of coming here. He failed to do that, and because of that, 144,000 people showed up at the southern border. If I become president on January 20, 2021, I'm going to do what this guy should have done and go and work with those countries so people will stay there because they can find safety and opportunity.
All right, 24 people died, and including sick kids in those detention facilities. Do you think Donald Trump has blood on his hands because of that?
I think this administration's cruelty has been part of the reason that we've seen these deaths. A good example of that is that we've seen 7 children who have died in the last year in U.S. custody. CBP custody. We had not seen a child die in their custody in more than 10 years, and we've had 7 die in 1 year. That's the level of cruelty and incompetence unprecedented of this administration, and I would end it.